Good morning, dear students. Today, I am teaching you the very first topic of mathematics grade 8. The name of the chapter is Rational Numbers. Rational Numbers. The very first question that arises: what is a rational number? Children, you might be knowing, which you have already studied in your previous classes, about integers. Integers are positive and negative both, including zero. So a rational number is a number, any number, which can be written in the form of P upon Q. Any number which can be written in the form of P by Q, where P and Q both are integers, and Q should not be equals to zero. Q means the denominator should not be zero. For example, any number which can be written in the form of P by Q. It means, suppose if I write 1 by 2, this is a rational number. Why? Because the numerator P is 1, and you all know that 1 is an integer. 1 is an integer, positive integer. 2 is the denominator which comes in place of Q, and 2 is also an integer. Another example, suppose minus 3 by 5, this is also an example of a rational number. Here minus 3 is an integer, negative integer. 5 is also an integer, which is a positive integer. Only number 11, this also comes in the category of rational numbers. Here you can see there is no digit, there is no value in the denominator, and we know that any number which is not having any denominator, we always consider 1. So this number is also representing the form P by Q. Here 11 is also an integer. There is no denominator, there is no value in place of Q, so we can consider as 1. So this is also an example of a rational number. Suppose any number which is given in the form of mixed, suppose 2 whole 1 by 5. This is also a rational number because it can be converted into the form of P by Q. 5 to the 10, 10 plus 1, 11 by 5. This is in the form of P by Q. If any number is like minus 3 by minus 11, this is also a rational number. Here you can see the numerator and denominator both are negative integers. No problem at all. This is also an example of a rational number. Overall, any number which can be written in the form of P by Q, where P and Q both should be integers, that number represents rational numbers. Suppose only number minus 13, this is also an example of a rational number. There can be infinite examples of rational numbers. Now, there are many questions based on this topic. The very first question which we will study today is how to represent rational numbers on number line. You all have studied in grade 6 and in grade 7 how to represent integers on number line.